Woo! Oddmar was despaired and lost. He wondered what Vaskar would have done in his place. As he thought about this, the fairy appeared by his side. With a heavy heart, the fairy told him,
I'm sorry that I put this burden on you. The fate of the forest and the fate of your people is now in Loki's hands.
Oddmar disheartenedly said,
Loki's curse is consuming my strength. I grow weaker by the day. Loki still has the key, and I don't know where he is.
The fairy looked toward Oddmar and said,
Loki has taken the key to the edge of the world. There the key can be used to open a portal between worlds. Your people are trapped there.
Oddmar knew what he had to do. He had to get to the edge of the world, and he had to face Loki and finish what Vaskar had started. The fairy's magic was fading, and she used the last of her powers to summon a guiding spirit for Oddmar.
Come on. Ah! Thank you.
It was still and quiet in the chamber. No more goblins. No more monsters. Just silence. The beautiful man-made carvings giving way to the natural forest and its magic. Here was the uneasy place where the world joined. It was as if the gods knew one day there would be a just cause for a mortal to travel beyond this place. Oddmar felt at home here. He had spent his life torn between the worlds in his own head and the world of Vikings. This was a place of compromise. Maybe his people could learn from this. Maybe they would no longer destroy and take. Maybe he could truly save them. Not just from death, but from themselves.
Loki emerged in front of the gate and said,
"Are you here to join your friends, Viking? You know, I could use someone like you in my army."
"I will never join you,"
Oddmar cried out as he charged towards Loki. He was ready to fight.
"Do you even think your people want to be saved by you?"
said Loki with a mocking smile.
"They will march in the army of the God of Chaos. They will be known as the ones who broke down the gates of Valhalla."
"No more lies!"
Oddmar bellowed.
He would not be manipulated.
"I have never told you a lie,"
said Loki confidently.
"I'm simply predicting your future."
Ah!
Oddmar had done it. But he did not know what waited for him behind that door. He would soon find out. His villagers looked broken and lost of all hope. They were astonished at the sight of Oddmar. They had misjudged him. They had not believed in him. But they would never doubt him again.
Vaskar,
said Oddmar as he embraced his old friend.
Your curse has been lifted. I barely recognize you.
Aye, said Vaskar. Now with Loki defeated, the fairies regained her strength. The fairy came forth and said,
You have done well, Oddmar. Take this. It shall lift your curse. Consider it a thank you gift from the forest.
Balance and order had been restored. Oddmar was no longer cursed. As he regained his strength, he realized that for the first time in his life, he believed in himself. In front of the gates of Valhalla, he looked up in awe, wondering if his parents were proud of him. Oddmar was not ready to meet them, not just yet, but he'd hoped he'd earned a place by their side. He had become a true Viking.